Hello everyone, in honor of the X-Files Season 11 arriving on home video, I decided to go over the X-Files movie from 1998, also known as Fight the Future. Now this is a very interesting movie. It works as a standalone episode of the X-Files. If you're a fan of the show, it's in between seasons 5 and 6. But if you're not familiar with the X-Files, I think you'll still highly enjoy the film. You don't need to watch the show to understand this movie. It's an isolated movie onto itself. I remember seeing this as a kid. I used to watch X-Files a little bit on reruns, but they used to air past my bedtime. So this is like the earliest introduction I had to the X-Files. I love it. Of course, you have David Duchovny as Fox Mulder, Gillian Anderson as Dana Scully, and William B. Davis as a cigarette-smoking man. In addition, you have appearances from Terry O'Quinn and Martin Landau. This is directed by Rob Bowman. Rob Bowman is a really great director. He directed a lot of great episodes in the television series, and he also directed the show Castle. So he knows how to do chemistry between two leads right, and he knows how to do suspense. The timing and everything is very, very well done. I still like this movie. Some people call it a glorified episode of the television show, but I like it. It feels like a movie. It's right after Independence Day. It's 1998. It still has that X-Files vibe. This is X-Files when it was at its highest peak of popularity. X-Files was the first show to use internet. And that was pretty early now in an age of social media. Originally, Chris Carter wanted to end the show after 5 seasons and continue on the story, or at least the mythology of the series, through anthology films, with this one being the start. But that had never happened. Fox thought it was too profitable, so instead they offered this in between 5 and 6. So whenever you have a marathon, go 1 through 5 and then watch this onto season 6 and it'll continue the stuff in this movie. That's pretty crazy. Not many other series can say they had 9 seasons initially, with 2 added event series and 2 feature films, especially one during its actual television run. That's impressive. That's like Mighty Morphin Power Rangers, a movie, another Fox property. The X-Files has a whole bunch of paranormal, supernatural occurrences in the show, but of course, this deals with the alien mythology. We get to see Earth a long time ago, and these cavemen find this black goo that's extraterrestrial. They get affected, and then we're fast forward where a group of kids find this cave, and in return find that same alien organism and become infected. Mark Snow does the music. He did the music for the show, and he has a really great score to this film that really amps up the anticipation and action. From then on, we cut to Mulder and Scully in Dallas, Texas, and they're looking for a bomb. There was a bomb threat, and they're FBI agents. They're away from the X-Files, and they go on this regular assignment. And, of course, everything goes south, and the building blows up. It's crazy. I remember first seeing this, and it was very similar to the Oklahoma City bombing. Something about it was just very intense. But it is one event that leads on to a greater story. You find out there was bodies there, and Mulder and Scully are like, there's nobody in the building. We evacuated the building. What happens? It's a cover-up. You find out it's the bodies of the kids that were infected from El Paso and other people. So Mulder and Scully investigate, why is this being covered up? Why are there other bodies? What's going on? And they delve deeper into an alien conspiracy with a shadow government. And I love it. This is all I'm going to give away of the movie. I'm going to go over my favorite moments in a minute, but if you've never seen The X-Files, stop this review and go see it. Seriously, the show's awesome. The movie is really good, especially the first one. But for those who have seen it, you know what it is. It's pretty much the X-Files mythology, and it's now called Fight the Future. I love it. I love this movie. I love Gillian Anderson and David Duchovny's chemistry. It was great here. The tension was still there, but it's before they got together, so there are certain moments where you're like, are Mulder and Scully going to kiss? And they did, in fact, but it was in a deleted scene. I love it. It has everything you want from the television show still. Even a slight nod to Independence Day, which the creator actually disliked, which is why Mulder's just pissing all over a poster. Crazy, I know, but I like the story to this. I like the pacing. It's a very good pace. It's only, let's see, 122 minutes, so it's only a 2-hour movie. It's pretty much an extended episode, but at some times it doesn't feel that way, especially towards the end. It's the alien stuff that really pays this off. And there is that one part with the bees. Oh my god, that part was insane. They actually had real bees for that scene. The vents going, Scully, run! I love that part. The part where Mulder gets shot when you find out the paramedics kidnap Scully and him trying to find her is just intense. That whole Antarctica part and the revelation of aliens is just insane. I love it. As an X-Files fan, it was a great moment. And I just wish more of the mythology in this was explored in the show. We kind of almost got there. And after a while, like many other television shows, it just went everywhere. And then to focus in on a super soldier storyline, and then eventually kind of going back to an alien mythology, but kind of retconning certain things. So, yeah, as part of the series, it's really great. But like most of the series with the alien mythology, it was building up to something that we really didn't get payoff for. But the other supernatural kind of like paranormal episodes of X-Files are what really help the show stand apart from others, especially with the Monsters of the Week. But if you look at this by itself, it's a solid film. It has its own story, its beginning, middle, and an end. And I like it. I mean, I didn't watch the X-Files show, like, religiously when I first saw this, so I had it on VHS. And yeah, I love it. It's a Fox classic. I give it 4 out of 5 and an A-. If you haven't seen X-Files Fight the Future, I highly, highly recommend it. This is an awesome movie. I love the Lone Gunman. So many great moments of this that I really like, with the music and even the cigarette smoking man, his mysterious kind of evil presence. And of course, that alien organism, which we did see in the show, it's like, what if Venom didn't inhabit a body, you know, like a symbiote? It's just crazy. So if you haven't seen it, definitely check it out. And if you have seen it, let me know your thoughts. What did you think of X-Files Fight the Future? Did you like it? What's your favorite X-Files season? Just let me know down in the comments below. You can also check out my Stardust reaction on the Stardust app at Fred Film Fanatic. Like, comment, and subscribe. Till next time, the truth is out there.